Now let's see about swapping in memory management. Swapping is mainly useful in order to implement multi-programming system. In a multi-programming system, we can store multiple processes in the main memory so that CPU can execute all those processes in an efficient manner. The major advantage of multi-programming is we can utilize the CPU performance in efficient manner. Let us take this example. It is a multi-programming system. In a multi-programming system, we have to divide the main memory into two parts. The first part stores operating system, whereas the second part stores user process. So this is nothing but user part, whereas the first part is nothing but it stores operating system. In multi-programming system, this user part is subdivided into various parts in order to store the processes. Here, the first part contains some operating system, and we have divided the second part into four partitions, where the first partition contains P1 process, next to P2 process, next to P3 process, next to P4 process. Here mainly there are two types of operations are available. The first type of operation is CPU operations, and the second type of operation is IO operations. We know that CPU instructions are executed in a faster manner. So CPU executes its instructions like arithmetic instructions, logical instructions in a faster manner, whereas IO instructions are dead slow. I stands for input operation, whereas O stands for output operations. Input operation means reading some data, whereas output operation means writing some data. In operating system, in order to perform read operation, we use read system call, whereas in order to perform write operation, we use write system call. Whereas if you take C language, then in order to perform the read operation, we have to open the file in read mode. Whereas in order to perform the write operation, we have to open the file in write mode. So here the point is, let us assume that process P1 is waiting for some IO operation. During IO operation, CPU is idle. Why? Because CPU can't perform the IO operation. It is the responsibility of operating system to perform the IO operation. So while process P1 is waiting for some IO operation, then CPU is idle. So what the operating system will do is, operating system allocates the next process to CPU. So CPU starts executing process P2. Let process P2 is waiting for some IO operation. So during that time, CPU is idle. Why? Because CPU can't perform IO operation. So what the operating system will do? Operating system allocates the next process, that is nothing but process P3, to CPU. So in this way, most of the time, okay, the CPU is very, very busy. So we can utilize the efficiency of the CPU in an effective manner with the help of the multi-programming system. Here, we know that CPU can access only the content of the main memory. CPU can't access the content of the secondary memory directly. So here, CPU can execute a program or a process if it resides in main memory only. Suppose if a process resides in secondary memory, then CPU can't execute that process. Okay. So here, let us assume that process P1 has completed its execution. So that means process P1 completed all its operations. So now there is no need of CPU for process P1. So here what will happen is, this process will be transferred to the secondary memory. So this transferring is known as swap out. So whenever process P1 completes its execution, then operating system transfers process P1 from main memory to the secondary memory. This transferring is known as swap out. There are various scenarios where the operating system transfers a process from main memory to the secondary memory. This is the first scenario. So what is the first scenario? If a process completes its execution, Then operating system transfers that process from main memory to the secondary memory. Why? Because the size of the main memory is very, very small when compared with secondary memory. So P1 completes all its operations. So we can store some other process in the main memory so that CPU can execute that process. Let us take another scenario where the transferring should be done from main memory to the secondary memory. Let process P1 is waiting for some IO operation. So during that time, CPU is watch idle. So there is no need of CPU for process P1. Why? Because it is waiting for some IO operations. So what the operating system will do? Operating system will transfers P1 from main memory to the secondary memory. And this is known as swap out. So this is the second scenario. Let us take the third scenario. Let us assume that process P1 is trying to access some operating system area or some other processes. So some protection violation will occur. So operating system will generate a trap or interrupt. So this process execution, the process P1 execution should be terminated. Why? Because it is trying to access other process area. Here operating system can access any process, but the corresponding process needs to access only those instructions only. So P1 should not access P2, P3, P4. P2 should not access P1, P3, P4. So in this situation, it is trying to access other area so that operating system generates a trap. So this process will be terminated. So that terminated process will be moved from main memory to the secondary memory. So this is the third scenario. Let us take a round robin algorithm. We know that in a round robin algorithm, we execute a process for a particular time quantum. Suppose if that time quantum is completed, then there is no need of CPU for that process. So CPU transfers that process from main memory to the secondary memory. If you take a priority scheduling algorithm, let us assume that process P1 is a low priority process. So while executing this P1 process, a high priority process comes into the ready queue, comes into the secondary memory. So during that time also, the CPU needs to stop the execution of process P1. So this process P1 should be transferred from main memory to the secondary memory in order to execute what? High priority process. So these are the various scenarios where a process will be transferred from main memory to the secondary memory, and this transferring is known as swap out. And now the CPU is free. That means CPU is ready to execute a process. Then a process will be transferred from secondary memory to the main memory, and this transferring is known as swap in. Let CPU completes process P1, process P2 and process P3 execution. Let P4 is waiting for some IO operations. So now the CPU is free. So what the operating system will do? Operating system transfers a process. It may be P5 or P6 or P7. It transfers, operating system transfers a process from secondary memory to the main memory. Why? Because here CPU executes a process if it resides in main memory only. So transferring process from secondary memory to main memory is known as swap in. So this is about swapping. So why we are using swapping? In order to improve the degree of multiprogramming. So degree of multiprogramming means keeping more number of processes in the main memory so that CPU performance will be very, very high. CPU can execute lakhs of processes simultaneously. So in order to keep the CPU very busy, we are using swapping technique.